Hello viewers, I just want to make this short video. I've often had some of my clients or fellow snail farmer complaining about the snail egg not hatching. So I want to use this farm as a case study because my client, which is my mother now, so because we've gone beyond the client's relationship, she's now my mother. So I want to use her case study. Her farm as a case study. She lost over 300 snail eggs, and that's huge. She lost over 300 eggs. So I'm here now just to make some recommendation and all that. So follow through as I do some correction and all that. Thank you. Now here, so I've just done this, so you can see this is moist now. Can you see this? This is moist. Now looking at this, number one, the eggs has been incubated, but then the bedding is not right because when the eggs were covered with soil, they were not properly covered. So now watch me as I do this. Are you seeing this that has been laid? Okay. Now I'm taking this sound. Can you see? That's still not enough. Even though it is covered, but it's still not enough. So I'm taking more sand or more soil. Can you see this? So I've covered this. Okay. Now, can you see this? I'm covering it. Now, if you look at this soil is not moist. It is dry. Though not 100% dry, but this soil you are seeing here is 95% dry. There is not 100% dry. So, egg will not hatch with this kind of environment, with this kind of soil. Can you see this? It is loose. Can you see that? And it is dry. Unlike this one that I just did, can you see how moist this? Can you see this now? This is moist. So, this will still keep your egg moist. Can you see that? Unlike this, this is loose and it is dry. Can you see it? So your snail egg will not hatch with this kind of soil. Can you see this? So this is the reason why she has lost such number of eggs. Unlike this, I can assure you these eggs here that I personally incubated, now you see the outcome of these eggs. I'm sure she will give the testimony. Can you see this? So I've just told her now in the next 2 days she should wet this incubator. This egg will still come alive. They will hatch with this soil moisture, but with this the eggs will not hatch. Can you see this? The eggs will not hatch. Now another contributing factor is that if you look at the bottom of this incubator, can you see it? It is not perforated. There's no hole there. They are not perforated, so in case the incubator is over wet or waterlogged, it means the egg will not hatch. The egg will lose its hatchability. But if you look at this one that I just did, I've perforated the you can't see it. Okay, I guess you can see that. Okay, can you see that there? So the bottom has been perforated. I just did that now, so there's no fear of being over wet. Because if the water is too much, the water will automatically drain off. So that is that. So you need to make sure that the eggs are well covered, do not over covered. Because if you add more soil or if you put too much of soil, it will be difficult for the snails to come alive, to come up off the soil. So just cover the soil with about 2 to 3 centimeters. You know, so that's just what you need. Now you can see this, they're not, can you see this? This is dry, and that's because it's not well covered. So if it's not well covered, the sun ray will dry it off, or even the air oxygen will dry it off. So you need to cover it well. Okay, you need to cover it well. You need to perforate the bottom of the incubator, and then you need to be wetting it every two or three days. If you want your egg to hatch, you need to be you need to perforate the bottom of the incubator the same way this the cover is perforated. The same way this cover is perforated, you need to perforate the bottom of the incubator itself. Okay, that's if you are using this model, if you are using this style, you have to perforate the bottom of the incubator. You need to perforate the cover of the incubator for oxygen sake, and you need to cover the soil itself. You need to cover the eggs with mulch soil, though not too much covering, but you just have to cover it properly so that there will not be air or sun ray penetration. And you need to be wetting it every 2 days. This is a case study now. I've just done this. I wet this. That's why you are seeing this. You can see how moist it is. But you can see how loose this is. With this kind of condition, your snail will not, your egg will not hatch. The hatchability will be lost. So that's why she has lost over 300 eggs. You can imagine 300 there. That's potential 300 snails. You can imagine what that could have given you. So from the stable of November's Farms or Shova Evolupe Snails, I'm wishing you all the best. I hope you've learned from that, and I hope that will be so helpful to you. Bye for now. Today being 11th of March, year 2021. So I hope when as I come up with I promise to still make some series of video concerning hatchability of your snail eggs. Okay, I promise to do that, at least just to still give you that kind of a reminder on how best you can have your eggs hatchable. Thank you. Bye for now.